statement. I shall now make a statement in my capacity as the representative of Indonesia. I would like to thank SRS Jiswan and AU Special Representative Maidera for their insightful briefings. I would also like to welcome Ambassador Abukar Dahir Osman, the permanent representative of Somalia, to this meeting. As the Secretary General has summed up, Somalia is at critical juncture. It is therefore crucial for all Somali stakeholders, supported by the international partners, to work together constructively. In this regard, I would like to highlight three points. First, we welcome the discussions between federal states leaders in Dusamar last July. The Security Council has repeatedly highlighted the need for Somalia's federal and state leaders to come together in a spirit of unity and compromise. We would like to stress that only through dialogue can Somali stakeholders move forward with the reform agenda that it has committed to undertake. We are hopeful that a consensus on the electoral modalities can be reached that enjoys the support of all stakeholders, particularly the Somali population. It is also important to advance the implementation of national priorities and state-building efforts. Second, we remain concerned over the security situation. We once again condemn all recent attacks by Al-Shabaab, including the attack at the elite hotel in Mogadishu last Sunday, as well as the mortar attack targeting the UN compound. In this regard, let me join others in extending our condolences to the people of and government of Somalia, in particular families of the victims, and would like to ask the perpetrators to be brought to justice. We would like to reiterate that any attack upon UN personnel is unacceptable and that all perpetrators must be brought to justice. We are concerned that despite continued operation against Al-Shabaab and the COVID-19 pandemic, Al-Shabaab remains capable of conducting larger, more complex, high-profile attacks. It is thus important to continue to build the capacity of Somali National Army, SNA, and equip it with the necessary training, including in countering IEDs. We commend the continued operations by the SNA and AMISOM to recover areas under Al-Shabaab control, as well as to disrupt its capacity to conduct terror attacks. In our view, it is important to accelerate force generation efforts to hold the recovered areas and pave the way for further stabilization activities. Third, Somalia is facing the triple challenge of COVID-19, flooding, and desert locusts. Increased support from international partners are needed now more than ever, particularly in support of the humanitarian response plan. Sustained support is also necessary to alleviate the economic impacts of the COVID-19 pandemic to ensure long-term recovery and resilience of the people of Somalia. We would also like to reiterate the importance of ensuring unimpeded humanitarian assistance and relief. I reaffirm Indonesia's respect for Somalia's sovereignty and territorial integrity and convey our utmost tribute to ANSOM, ANSOS, AMISOM, and all actors working to ensure lasting peace and stability in Somalia. What happens in the next few months will determine the future of Somalia. We hope that all Somali stakeholders remain committed in their pursuit of dialogue and reconciliation to ensure peace and prosperity in the country. I resume my function as President of the Council, and I now give the floor to the distinguished